general feeling amongst physicists for the last 100 years is that we need to quantize space-time just as we quantize every other field. But reconciling gravity with quantum theory is one of the great challenges of physics. Thus far, we've been hopelessly unsuccessful. And so I think we're at a point where we ought to really question whether this drive and this challenge to quantize gravity, whether that really was the right thing to do. My name is Jonathan Oppenheim. I'm a physicist at University College London. And myself and my students have proposed a theory of gravity where matter remains quantum, but somehow gravity is treated classically. It's an attempt to reconcile the fact that our current theory of gravity, which is general relativity, is inconsistent with quantum mechanics. In physics, we have these two frameworks, quantum mechanics and classical mechanics. All the particles and all the fields and different forces and electromagnetism and all that we know in nature that we've discovered, they all obey quantum theory. But quantum theory doesn't describe gravity. Our theory of gravity is general relativity, discovered by Einstein, and it is a theory of space-time. So it tells us that space-time bends, and it is not a quantum theory at all. The general feeling amongst physicists for the last 100 years is that gravity is a force just like any other force, and therefore should be quantized just like every other force, and fit into the framework of quantum theory. But gravity is different. Gravity is very simple in some ways. Almost all of gravity is just that clocks run at different speeds in different places. And that amazingly gives you the curvature of space-time. Gravity is very much about the arena or the background in which matter moves. So you have this quantized matter which evolves in time and moves in space, and this background space-time appears to be a necessary part of how we describe quantum theory. So let's say you believe that we should quantize space-time. What we're doing is we're quantizing how fast clocks run. And it turns out if you try and quantize that, you're essentially quantizing the speed of time. And if you quantize the speed of time, what you find is that time becomes frozen. Things don't evolve at all. So this is the immediate problem that people grappled with when they were trying to quantize gravity, and we've, I think, been stuck on that ever since. The black hole information paradox, or annoyance or problem, however you want to describe it, is probably one of the most fascinating conundrums we have in physics. It somehow seems to hold the key to the way to reconcile gravity and quantum theory. It's a problem which comes about because of Hawking's discovery that black holes appear to thermally radiate. So if you throw a known quantum state, a known item, into a black hole, then the black hole will just radiate it away thermally in a way that seems to completely destroy the information that was thrown into the black hole. If you believe in a fully quantum theory of gravity, you're pretty well compelled to believe that information has to come out of a black hole, and therefore you have a bit of a paradox. But it's only a paradox if you believe that physics somehow has to be deterministic, predicting everything with certainty. It's not a paradox if you don't believe that physics is deterministic, if you believe that there can be noise and stochasticity and randomness. If you believe that, then it's not really a paradox at all. You throw in a known state into the black hole and it comes out random, and that's just the way life is. And I think a lot of physicists are very uncomfortable if there's a fundamental stochasticity or randomness. Kilograms squared, seconds, meters to the minus. The idea that we can consistently couple quantum systems and classical systems has been around since the 90s. And it was exciting to me that these two frameworks somehow can be made to fit together. If space-time is fundamentally the classical background in which matter moves, then things become easier in many different ways. So for example, you now can have an evolving space-time. The black hole information paradox no longer is a paradox. Information can be destroyed if the background space-time is classical. And so what we, you know, myself and my students were able to prove is that any consistent theory of coupling between classical degrees of freedom and quantum degrees of freedom have to be fundamentally stochastic. Any theory in which gravity is fundamentally classical has to have this randomness, and the amount of randomness you have is a lot.
Okay, 10 to the minus 1 upper bound.
And then the lower bound is 10 to the minus 40. So a few years ago, after I'd given a talk on the theory, I got into a discussion with Carlo Rovelli, who's one of the founders of loop quantum gravity. And as a result of that discussion, we formulated a bet with 5,000 to 1 odds on whether space-time is fundamentally quantum or not. Jeff Pennington, who's a leading string theorist, also joined in on the bet. If I win, I will get 5,000 items from each of them. Maybe some olive oil or a little dram of whiskey, maybe a packet of crisps. And so what I like about the bets is that they force us to, first of all, make the bet precise in a way that can be tested experimentally, because I think that's important, that we can test our beliefs experimentally. We have these experiments that we're proposing, looking for randomness in the gravitational field, which are, I would say, an indirect test of a quantum theory of gravity, in that they're maybe more of a test of a classical theory of gravity. But of course, if you don't find randomness and noise in the gravitational field, then you can rule out the classical theory of gravity. So we measure the gravitational field, say, produced by 1 kilogram mass, and we can measure how much noise there is in a precision test of gravity. And then we can go out and we can measure how long we can put a massive object in superposition. So you imagine a gold atom, for example. And those two experiments squeeze any theory in which gravity is treated fundamentally classically. It squeezes it from two directions. We're all really struggling to solve this problem. We've been struggling for 100 years. And so those experiments will determine the outcome of the bet.